Chevron signs are proven to reduce serious and fatal crashes on rural curves. This video series shows how to install the slow cost countermeasure correctly to save lives in your community. The placement of chevrons is dependent on the radius of the curve and the advisory speed. This video focuses on a simple procedure to determine the radius of a curve and the spacing of chevrons. Matt Ulberg is the director of the Montana Local Technical Assistance Program. He has developed a unique way for practitioners to determine the radius of the curve so chevron signs can be placed correctly on rural curves.
So I use the analogy of a box. And when you order a pizza in a box, the pizza touches the outside of that box at each of the four sides. Each corner of that box represents a geometric point, and each place where that pizza touches the side represents a geometric point that is analogous to curvilinear geometry in roadways. So if you assume a direction on that pizza box from the lower right corner to the upper right corner, you will be going on a tangent until you touch that pizza crust, jump onto the pizza crust at the PC, travel around the crust to the next point at the top of the box, which is the PT. So PC, PT, and then continue along that tangent of the box. The PI is the corner of the box, which on a roadway, if you have fences running along your right of way, that fence corner is pretty close.
Matt uses the pizza analogy along with simple online tools to determine sign spacing.
I like the online tools because you can visualize circular geometry placed on a landscape in three dimensions if you want. So using Google Earth, there's a measurement tool, which is this little ruler. You bring that up, there's options, a line, a path, a polygon, circle. We'll be using the line and the circle. So now we have two tangent alignments, which are the edges of our pizza box. We have to determine the radius that touches each of those equally. So if this is the PC, and we go perpendicular to the center of the pizza, and this is the PT, and we go perpendicular, the center should be very close to the intersection of those two. So we're going to have a curve radius that's in the neighborhood of 80 feet. This is 77.3.
Use the chevron spacing table from the manual on uniform traffic control devices to determine sign spacing based on the advisory speed determined from the speed study and the curve radius you just found. If advisory speed and radius indicate different sign spacing, use a smaller spacing of the two.
So the curve radius classification, the breakdown, is less than 200 feet is one spacing. And then the next grouping is 200 feet to 400 feet. That's a lot of curves. And then from 401 feet to 700 feet. So they're in these large bands of radius. So if you can get close with an online tool, you're probably going to be close enough.
Now that you know the spacing of the signs, plot them out around the curve, adjusting as needed to work around roadside objects.
The spacing should be maintained. Sometimes the array has to shift a little, but if we rotate them this way and get that gap even on each side from the PC to the PT, that's a more equitable thing.
Once you plan sign placement, it's time to install them.
So now in the field, since we know conceptually what the PC and the PT are, we can physically occupy that space and make a judgment call as to where the curve starts and the tangent starts and place a stake. And we'll place a stake at this location where the curve starts and the tangent starts.
Video 2 in this series shows how to use these calculations to install chevron signs in the field.